This is the long arm yarn topper I was talking about. I couldn't remember, but I finally found the reference, and it's also referred to as the praying mantis, just because of the way it looked. This little coil of wire here is simply, it's a counterweight. It's not for the yarn to feed through. It's what keeps slight pressure and keeps this is the brake, the yarn brake, and keeps it balanced. The default would be the on position so that the yarn doesn't feed back. Okay, on the spring setup that I've got here, originally had to look like a coil out of a wire coil notebook, and I took that off and came up this. I sent you some pictures, but here's some things again. So you get this, you can get this little collar stop, and with a 5/16 hole in it. I'll let you do the conversion. It comes with a short little set screw in there to use a little Allen wrench. You can take that out. You also get at the hardware these little thumb screws to go in. That gives us a couple of things. That gives us, makes this adjustable. It also makes a place for the spring to attach to down here. The springs are just something fairly light. I think this one comes from our local Home Depot. Had several springs in it. This one, I think a few others. I fixed some of these for some other people. It's fairly light duty spring. Also, this one was from through an Ace Hardware, and it's from the Century Spring Corporation, and it's a C77 for what that's worth on it. And I think that's actually what I've got on this one right now. So that's another possibility, but it doesn't have to be a real strong, just enough to really raise this back up on it. And so normally when I take my topper off, I just unhook that spring and leave this contraption here set up on it. Okay, let me set this here, tighten it down for a moment so it's not swinging around on me too much, and we'll go through how this gets threaded. So come up through our eyelet, as I said, and there's a little hook right here that whatever kind of spring you use, conceivably you could even mess around and make some little weights out of some BBs or a little steel bar or something, even just hook on that. But then I just hook that spring right here on the end of this, and that keeps that, that's called the heel spring, toe spring, that will keep the pressure when you reverse directions to do that. And I think I may have mentioned, once I thread this all up, I leave the heel spring on all the time. It gives me a nice consistent loop, a knit on it. I don't have to worry about having kind of a loose knit and then getting down to the make the heel and it being okay for it, and then remembering to take it back off and hook it back up to make two identical socks. It just, you make the one adjustment and stays there, and it works nice all the way through. Okay, so I'm going to come up and I'm going to go between those two little fingers here that sticks up. I'm going to go under this weight, under this brake, and the yarn then goes in that little trough here, as I discussed. Goes through this loop, comes up here to the spring, and that's loaded then. Now see, I usually can do that, just reach up one-handed to do that. But the yarn is coming through the fingers. There's a little trough here. This break, you can see this, it's effective. It doesn't take much, just a little bit, to hold that yarn from backing off when this is coming up. When this gets, while you're cranking, this is pulling down, that takes the pressure off of the brake, enough pressure off of it that it lets the yarn feed on through. So So that's the essence of that, and I will go through that here one more time. Up through the yarn feeding loop here, between the two fingers, goes under the break into the little groove that's set up here, goes once around the part here, up, drops into there, and then you thread your yarn feeder on the machine and you're ready to crank.